Hi Scorpio, welcome to your reading for August 2022. This is going to be for Scorpio Sun, Moon, or Rising. You're going to have planets in the sign of Scorpio. You may be in love with the Scorpio. I know I have Scorpios I love. My daughter, October 29th. My brother is November 6th. Or you could have someone romantically that you love, that's a Scorpio. You may be intuitively guided. You know, sometimes, how do you know that? You know, sometimes you just scroll by a video, but like something, maybe it's the title or the thumbnail, something sticks. And it's almost like it's making you go back. You know, I feel like that's your guides, that's your intuition, there's a message. It doesn't even matter what sign it is. Sometimes the messages are, you know, it is about trusting your gut. So anyway, and listen, we've been together here on YouTube, many of us, for a very long time, and we've had tremendous spiritual growth. I know that. I see it. I know I can tell by the cards, you know, what cards you used to come up all the time are coming up very seldom now, the difficult ones. So, you know, I see the growth, and I feel your energy, whether you feel mine or not. And, you know, how do you know if a reading is for you? You should feel it. You know, if you're guessing, but you're not feeling it, it's there could still be a message for you, but it may not be that particular scenario. And remember, spirit uses, like, let's say one scenario, but there can be a variety within that one scenario. Does that make sense? Anyways, let's get into reading, guys. I feel like Scorpio needs this reading right now. I feel like Scorpio is looking, seeking advice, and I hope that I can give it to you. So we're going to use three different decks. We're going to start with our Mother Mary Oracle. Love it, always. You know, the respect as the first card. Then we will use the Cosmic Tarot. It's a deck that I used to use all the time. I use, you know, here and there now, but I felt called to it for you. And then we're going to use the Light Seer's Tarot, which is a tarot that I love for you. I don't know why, I just do. There's certain signs, there's certain decks call to me, and sometimes I'll use the opposite. But this time, I feel like you really need clarity, let's say. So let's get into the reading. Cosmic Tarot will be what we will use to clarify, or to go a level deeper, is how I like to say it. Excuse that noise if you hear in the background. Sam is, for some reason, playing with the speakers, trying to, what's that word, synchronize them. Some of you, I feel like that's what you're heading towards. Just like, you know, feeling out of sync right now. And, moving back into it. Okay, remember, energy is temporary. Energy changes. You know, where there's bad, there will be good, right? As long as I'm seeking it. Anyway, let's go. Let's go. Mother Mary. Okay, well, you got a lot, but they're all face up. Now, you know, most of you know I read this at the end of the reading. That's where the words are most profound. I'm not going to read all of them, but I'll read the ones we feel called to. But let's see what we have. Okay, we have quiet. I can't believe you got four cards and they're all face up. I go into peaceful silence and I listen. I go into peaceful silence and I listen. Gratitude. As I notice and appreciate my blessings, I open the door to more of God's gifts. As I notice and appreciate my blessings, I open the door to more of God's gifts. Open your heart. Open your heart. I allow myself to feel the full range of emotions, especially all forms of love. I allow myself to feel the full range of emotions, especially all forms of love. I have a feeling as it's relating to like a romantic love, there are highs and there's lows, right? For better or for worse. Open your heart. And last but not least, faith. Faith. Beautiful. I don't know why I'm repeating everything twice. I have faith in God to heal this situation. I have faith in God to heal this situation. It normally means I need to step out of the way. Something may be, you know, out of my control and I'm trying to control it, but really I can't. Put it in God's hands. God will control it. Have that faith, right? Quiet, gratitude, open your heart, and then faith. Wow. Okay. We'll see how they all play in the reading. I feel like that alone was a reading. So we're going to use the Light Seers Tarot. Of course, you guys know, majority of you know, everything is always pre-shuffled. But I do like to give it a shuffle or two with you here. Give them a cut. And, you know, normally I shuffle for the cards, but I have to tell you, I feel guided to pull them off the top as in a story form. So I'm going to follow that. All right, we have the Six of Pentacles. Six of Pentacles. You know, it's a good energy, but it becomes good once I have certain realizations. I move from the Five of Pentacles to the Six of Pentacles. So whatever happened in the Five of Pentacles, that's the energy where you feel thrown out into the cold. So, you know, something's out of your control, but you still have to keep moving forward. You know, Six of Pentacles signifies that you did. But the Six of Pentacles is also, it talks about balance. You know, allowing myself to receive as much as I give, you know, equally. You know, it's the give and take. It's a give and take. This is a very compassionate type energy, and I do feel like it's talking about your heart, you, who you are, you're naturally. And I know some people who had dated Scorpios, and listen, I was married to a Scorpio, but different than my daughter. You know what I mean? There's so many characteristics that go into a human character. Anyway, what am I saying? I do feel like, you know, it's your heart. And it's just, you know, am I, you know, is receiving and giving in my life equal? What we want to make sure in the Six of Pentacles is who we give to, that it expands the world, right? It expands the energy. It's good for all type of thing. This isn't about just giving and someone just keep taking. We have the Five of Cups. We have the Seven of Cups. Wow. You know what I'm feeling all of a sudden, Scorpio? I'm also feeling the energy of like traveling through the seasons. Like right now, I'm in this energy of a lot of emotions. First of all, we're in the energy of Cancer, moving into the energy of Leo. So there is a lot of, and then Scorpio on top of that, there's a lot of emotional type energy. So, you know, the Five of Cups is like, it's the energy of, let's say in its most extreme form, it's where I'm thinking about all that I have lost, right? All that I have lost. And I can get stuck in that energy. And that's why it's a five, because five says, take a look at this. This is about change. So it's almost like, am I putting all my eggs in one basket and thinking they're the only eggs I have when there's two eggs that have yet to be discovered? I don't know why I'm saying eggs. But the Seven of Cups next to that, it's you know, first of all, it talks about the energy that may be around you, and it can feel chaotic, and that, again, is why you may need to take this quiet time out. Because if I'm trying to make a decision in the Seven of Cups, again, it's like I'm not trusting myself either. And then we have the Emperor. Can be an Aries, of course. This Emperor, let me put this a couple different ways. I feel like the Emperor is someone, you know, that I look up to for maybe many different reasons, but I also feel the energy of, you know, it's kind of like, I don't know. I don't want to say my way or the highway. All right, let's keep going. We have the Page of Cups. We have the Ace of Cups. Under that, Five of Cups. We have the King of Swords. Can be a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Doesn't have to be. And then when we look at this, we have the Four of Cups. How interesting. How interesting, because I feel like, first of all, this Empress energy, like, I can look up, and again, don't worry about the sign, think of the person, right? This is someone that normally I look up to, right? There's certain aspects I respect due to their action, right? It's their action. However, this Emperor has the Four of Cups under it, so it's being more inactive, not so much active. And that may be why his head is this way, right? But in the Five of Cups comes what it produces, probably after this change, is the Ace of Cups. I don't know if it's with that person. I don't know if it's with this person. I don't know if I'm deciding between these two people. Hello, Queen of Cups. Just look at her image, first of all. She's connecting. As above, so below. That means many different things. But the one thing it can mean for you is this human walk that you're on right now. This is not the first time you've been here. This is not the first time you've been in love. It's not the first time, you know, that you've overcame something. It's not the first time we're making decision, you know, is difficult. But what it is your higher self saying, I'm there with you, right? We can get through this. You know, because if anything, this is about being true to you, number one, being true to you. So anyways, the Queen, very connected. Coming at the Page above her, Page of Cups, and the Six of Pentacles. We have the Nine of Pentacles. This talks about independence. This is about success. Some of you, it's about your own business. And, you know, it's coming under the Ace of Cups also. It's so, I feel like it's an opportunity to love what you do. Doesn't make it easy, right? Doesn't mean that everything's a cakewalk, But what it does mean as, you know, I focus upon it, it grows and grows and grows. The Nine of Pentacles is a very independent energy. And, you know, I'm looking at the Five of Cups mirroring it, right? So it can be like one or two ways, maybe. The Ace of Cups is still here. It's connecting them. So, you know, as I'm moving through this energy, and again, it may just be temporary, energy that does not feel so good emotionally, maybe as I move into my creativity, even if I'm using my own experience, and sometimes that's where you find the most success because you've been there, you've done that, you get it as much as you can, and you learn as you go. So anyways, don't be surprised if, like, sometimes the energy or the pause is to move you, right? Is to inspire you to create this Nine of Pentacles, because you're right next to it, and it has something to do with your connectivity as above, so below. You know, and another way you can look at that is it doesn't feel like, you know, you walk this path alone. And I mean that on a spiritual basis, right? So it's using what I have learned. I am connected, right? I am always connected to above. You know, I want to go to heaven where heaven can be on earth. I want to create heaven here on earth. We have the Knight of Swords. And then we have the Seven of Pentacles. Interesting. So we open with Six of Pentacles, and the last card on this spread is the Seven of Pentacles. Okay, I feel like there's a couple different things I can look at here. First of all, the Six of Pentacles, you know, who am I giving my time to? Is it equal, right? Is it, you know, the Six of Pentacles is about learning compassion and empathy, but also giving it out to those that will expand through it. At the same time, I feel like almost like, you know, did I give too much? Because then the Five of Cups shows up, and the Five of Cups talks almost like, you know, I miss what I had. I miss what I had, but change is still on the horizon, right? But let's not forget, in that Five of Cups, there are still two cups. There's still two cups. She's just not focused on them right now. But maybe it's because her focus moves down to the Nine of Pentacles, and she's building this foundation, this independence for herself. You know, and this is something that no one can take away. You know, this is when I'm in this energy, towers, you can't affect me, right? Because my foundation is too strong. So maybe I'm moving out of my emotional house and into my creative house in some way that may help. You know, the Five of Cups is change again. And sometimes we can't stop that change. But the Seven of Cups next, though, I feel like, you know, it's like I'm teeter-tottering back and forth. Do I keep my focus on this egg and this basket? Or do I open my horizons to other baskets? I don't know. Let me say one thing. No matter how this turns out, I can say with the Seven of Pentacles here, I feel like your soul, it's your soul's seed of intention. Otherwise, it's something your soul wanted to experience in this lifetime. Doesn't always mean it's forever, but it's like becomes a pinnacle. Like, where were you in 2022? And like, boom, I can remember immediately. You know, where were you in 1989? I don't know. You know what I mean? All right, let's look at the bottom of the deck. Look at this. We have the Nine of Cups. Joy, happiness, inner harmony. Two nines. You know, nines are always about reflection, also. Like, you know, I can reflect back at my pentacles and see, you know, where I am today and know exactly why I am today. I just need to look back. Same with the Nine of Cups. Nine of Cups is the same, you know, it's finding joy within. And maybe it's just knowing that, hey, those two cups that have yet to be discovered will be discovered in their time. The King of Pentacles underneath that. Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. Doesn't have to be. All right. Let's bring in the Cosmic Tarot, and I'm going to start at the top line. We have the Empress. Beautiful. The Empress, first of all, coming over the Six of Pentacles. You know, this is what I feel. I feel like what you would call mistakes in your life, or maybe at one time you did, has really been about your growth. It's been about what you've learned. It becomes your wisdom. First of all, we have the Empress and we have the Emperor here. Empress is coming over the Six of Pentacles. Did the Empress give more than the Emperor? You know, it may be a quick lesson, but I feel like this Empress, I feel like, you know, listen, nobody can really pull the wool over the Empress's eyes, at least not for long. And sometimes I give because it makes me feel good, right? But also, now it's about also, you know, like being open. Okay, anyway. Interesting, we have the Emperor and the Empress. We have the Prince of Swords. We have the Nine of Cups again. Interesting. This Five of Cups could also signify someone, the way they speak. Prince of Swords, I feel like, you know, when I think of a prince or a princess, I think of someone who is learning their craft, and their craft is a sword, and that sword is about communication and truth, and uniqueness and honesty. You know, they have to find themselves to really define another. I don't even know what I mean by that. But I feel like it's almost like something came, some type of communication may have came. And that may have been why now there's the Five of Cups, but also the Seven of Cups. So again, you're questioning something here. It's interesting because the Empress has the Nine of Cups right here. The Emperor has the Nine of Cups kind of over him. Really, it's over the Seven. But because of my microphone, well, hello. Okay. Wanted to come out. We have the Hermit. Can be a Virgo. Interesting. Why am I feeling like there's three nines? Oh, one, two, three. Two are of the same. You know, the Hermit is going to talk about time. Because, you know, this is coming over the Emperor's energy. And I almost feel like the Empress. I mean, listen, I feel like, you know, what can the Empress work on? Well, you know, it's kind of showing, like, not focusing on, you know, it's hard to say the sadness of something, but instead, like, okay, well, then what do I do, Sandy? It feels like I turn that focus over to my creativity, and I build my own foundation, and it's just talking about the foundation, but it's also talking about success directly connected to you, and also, it feels like, something that, you know, like, what, Sandy, what? Well, it's something that lies within your heart. And the Page of Cups next to that makes me feel like, you know, it's just a talent that you have. It's something within you. It can even be something that you remember from your younger years, right? And that's the way you move. Anyway. And I feel like as I go down this line, even though this prince is over here, I can still see him here. So I feel like, you know, we have the Prince of Swords and then we have the King of Swords. So we have progression, right? But we have the Knight of Swords underneath that. And I'm taking this slow because I really want to understand this. So the Emperor is the one who's in the Hermit energy. Listen, I'm seeking the light, right? Even though it feels like, in a way, the Empress is, I feel like the Empress is already receiving the light. She just has to know that. I feel like the Emperor, on the other hand, you know, it can even speak about these two spiritual journeys and, you know, one not quite being quite where the other is. I do feel the sense of joy and happiness, though. You know, I feel the joy and happiness. And it's interesting because the Four of Cups below the Emperor, it's almost like somebody is not putting action. And the Emperor is all about action. Right? He's the leader of the pack. I mean, but listen, in the Four of Cups, it also talks about using your spiritual discernment. This may be them figuring out their own spiritual journey. You know what I mean? But the Hermit, it does feel like, you know, I almost feel like I'm the type of person where I cannot learn unless I go through it. You know what I mean? It's like a million people can tell me no, but unless I go through it, that's what makes me understand. It's interesting because I'm seeing all these stars like coming out of this lantern. So, okay, well, let's keep going. Okay, now we're moving into the sevens. We have the Seven of Swords. We have the Seven of Wands. And we have the High Priestess. Okay. Seven of Wands is the energy of defending oneself. Listen, I feel like it's saying that maybe this Empress, due to, like, you know, listen, the Empress has come to clarity, but that doesn't mean she's perfect, right? The Empress not perfect. We're still human. It just means I've had a lot of experiences. I've learned from them, right? My wisdom has increased. My creativity, it's like my second name. This is someone who trusts their intuition. The intuition is my GPS. But it took time for me to get here. I had to live the life of all the queens, the emperor. I had to live the life of all the kings, right? So that it gives a much greater understanding. That is what I feel like true wisdom is. Now, that's just me saying that. Anyway. I feel like, you know, I'm not going to lie. I feel like the Empress, because the Seven of Swords is under that, and that can be untrustworthy energy. You know, that can certainly be because the Seven of Wands is next to that. So there's something, you know, that feels deceptive within this that then can easily move into the ego type energy. I don't know if that would serve anyone, right? I don't know if that would serve anyone because then comes the High Priestess. Listen, if you know what you know, then you know. Then you act accordingly, right? as this relates to making a decision, because it's also coming over the Seven of Cups, where like I'm deciding, do I want this cup? Do I, you know, which cup do I choose? There is again your intuition, right? You're like, trust that. Don't second guess it, right? Listen, energy can be not right and just be not right for that moment, right? But listen, maybe this Emperor, again, going through the energy of the Hermit, which only means they're going to be wiser at the end, right? They're going to be much wiser at the end. Their light becomes a beacon for others. That can only be a good thing, but it doesn't mean that, you know. Anyway, keep going. I'm seeing sevens and nines so far. Look at that, the Seven of Cups again. You know, it's like this Emperor, if this Four of Cups belongs to the Emperor, again, it's the energy of not really doing much about something. Doesn't mean that I don't have a dream, right? This Four of Cups, there is a cup that I do fantasize about, but it's showing because this Emperor now is wrapped around the Seven of Cups. So this may be the Emperor who is having a hard time with this energy, right? But it's interesting because you both show in this reading. We have, look at this, a Six of Pentacles again. This is just you finding yourself, I'm telling you. Here's the Queen, right? She's connecting to above with the Six of Pentacles. Here you again are as the Empress over the Six of Pentacles. Well, hello, Ten of Cups. And then we have Justice. You know, that feels like, how do I want to say this? First of all, it's a card of Libra. And I have to tell you, I feel like my sister, who is a Libra, often is in my daughter's readings because she's a Scorpio. So I want to say that. When I say that, I mean your guides also. And listen, I feel like my sister's been with us, you know, in our readings for so long. She's just a staple. Anyway, we have the Ten of Cups. Beautiful. I feel like, listen, let's go back to this Five of Cups, right? Because here's the Five of Cups. It does eventually move into the Ten of Cups, but the Nine of Pentacles is underneath that. So I do feel like, and listen, I feel like both having this Nine of Cups is like the enjoying of each energy, right? But maybe both, you know, like I feel like this Emperor is like working on his spirituality. I feel like this Empress is, you know, taking what feels like a loss and moving it into her creative house, which is promising success. This is like working out of the home with the Nine of Pentacles and now the Ten of Pentacles, or the Ten of Cups. Ten of Cups is a happy, loving home. Justice is about making you whole again. You know, justice is fairness. Coming over the Seven of Pentacles is coming over the Knight and the Seven of Pentacles. Seven of Pentacles is your soul of intention. Listen, I don't feel like this is singular soul's intention, but I feel like, you know, if it's our soul's intention, it doesn't mean we said, okay, like, I want to meet this person, I want it to be easy, and bam, that's that. No, because from a soul's point of view or your spirit's point of view, it's like whatever challenges lie ahead, I know, or at least I challenge myself to get through them. And that may be why justice is here. It's like, you know, the what feels like karma in life, right? It's really your soul saying, you know, like, I'm daring myself. That makes sense? Okay, all of these are in reverse, which is interesting because we have the Ten of Wands. Boom. We have the Ten of Swords. Look at that, in reverse. Look at the swords drop out. Listen, first of all, Ten of Wands. in the upright. This is a period of time of feeling like everything is on your shoulders, right? It's all on your back. This is you saying, This is you knowing, you know, what your response, you know, it's like, this is a period of what feels like heavy, responsible time. But I feel like in this energy, I'm carrying other people's weight at the same time, and it's not fair to you. This is, in reverse, this is the realization of that. It's like the release of that. And then, I mean, hello, you know, sword after sword after sword after sword after sword. Excuse my language, but it's like, fuck you. No way. I'm letting these swords drop out of my back. Why are you doing that? I feel like because you're learning. You're really, really learning. You're really learning, right? Like in the Ten of Wands, I can't control. What I can't control, I am not going to hold on to it. And the Ten Swords is like, I've been here. I've done that over and over and over. This can be a pattern. I just put a post out about a pattern. You know, awareness is seeing the pattern. Growth is doing something about it. Is cutting the ties to that pattern. That's what Ten of Swords is. Like I feel like you're just making this decision of like, I'm not carrying this shit around. I don't know why I'm being so. Then we have the King of Swords. Interesting, because we do have the King of Swords here too. And then we have the Hierophant. Okay. I don't know why I'm over here. Simply put, I feel like you, if you're the Empress, I feel like you're making great strides in your life. Sometimes it doesn't feel like it, right? But it's also the epiphanies of the Empress. You know, again, my daughter, I'm sorry to keep bringing up her name, but she's a Scorpio, and she always has ideas. Her only problem is moving upon them, right? She receives great epiphanies. And I feel like many of them are meant to be, but it's like, you can't, you know, someone will trust within that when they trust within that. Like, you can't, that's not something you can force. So anyways, I'm comparing that because I feel like this Empress is learning something, and so is this Emperor. But this Emperor is like, you know, learning it, you know, it can be like on the same vibration, but like different ways. Don't think that these two aren't influencing each other. It feels like in a positive way because they both carry that Nine of Cups energy. And I feel like the minute I, like, listen, I trust my gut and I'm not going to allow myself to carry the weight of anything and anyone. Listen, if things don't want to, how do I say this? I feel like I'm strong enough now in myself that it doesn't mean that I can't accidentally, you know, carry this Ten of Wands, that I forget about that Ten of Swords. No, it doesn't mean that. But what it means is you've had clarity over it. And I feel like in the Ten of Wands reverse, it's like you're letting go of it, right? You're not allowing yourself to go into an ego type energy. Why? Well, it just wouldn't serve you. All of a sudden, I can't believe all the sevens out. I feel like, you know, this Seven of Cups mirrored by the Seven of Swords, if I have any questions, let's say from the Empress to the Emperor, I feel like this is, you know, allowing someone to show themselves. You, because both, you know, here is the Six of Pentacles again. You know, the Five or the Hierophant, let's say, can be a card of Taurus, by the way. It is in reverse. And it can speak of someone's faith, right? And it may be something that needs to be built, that type of thing, like, sometimes they need a good look at their own ego in this energy, right? Like, like bad things happen to me, but yet they're like, I feel like this King of Swords causes it. Like, bad things happen to me, but it's my fault. Now, I don't know who this represents to you. Let's follow that. By the way, look at this, three tens. Three tens, three sevens at least. Synchronicities. Okay, well, there's another 10, but this is a great 10. This is a 10 of Pentacles. There is such a difference here. You know, because when I'm in the 9 of Pentacles, again, I'm strong within myself. I'm independent within myself. This can speak financially, creatively, but it's also speaking about the inner you, right? My inner joy, that type of thing. I feel like it's almost like when... You know, when the student is ready, the teacher will appear. Look at these tens. The tens that are the hardest in tarot are reversed. Now, it is towards the end of your reading, and I feel like this is just realization. How soon can this happen? I feel like as soon as you have that realization. And then the 10 of Pentacles. Stability. Rooted in time. We have, again, the Queen of Cups. With the Two of Swords. Almost like, you almost had me, Sandy, but can I do this? Can I do this? Can I release half this responsibility? Can I release these daggers? I feel like yes. There is a blindfold in the Two of Swords. Look at that. Wow, and look at that. Eight of Pentacles. Trusting yourself. This talks about new beginnings. You already have the Nine of Pentacles that moves into the Ten of Pentacles, right? I feel like as the Empress, you know, like don't fear success because you just may be made for it. And a lot of times when I see the Empress, I think it is exactly from her experiences that make her wise and empathetic and compassionate and strong, right? The lamb and the lion. Eight of Pentacles. I'm not afraid to be the apprentice. I'm not afraid to try something new because I know if I put my focus on it, I will grow it. I need to trust that within myself. And then comes the Two of Pentacles. A much more logical look at one's life. You know, the Two of Pentacles can be, many call it the juggler's energy, but I often feel it's like, is this something that's going to expand my world? Is this something that, you know, if I'm adding someone to it, let's say, you know, will they love me for uniquely who I am? If this is about what I do for a living or through my creativity, you know, will they love me for who I am? Now, I already know the answer is yes. I already know that. You know, but I cannot rip that blindfold off. You have to rip it off yourself if you choose. So it's nothing, like, I feel like nothing here, though it can feel major. I feel like there's certain realizations, right? Maybe when I get quiet and I move into a place of gratitude, it does open my heart, and this is keeping the faith, right? However you want your life to look doesn't mean it's going to look exactly the way you want it to look, but, you know, it looks good, probably better. All right, I'm not going to leave it on a question. I know this is long, but I feel like you guys needed a little bit extra long. Look at that. We have the Nine of Pentacles again, and we have the Five of Swords. So there's something related to your Nine of Pentacles that talks about your creativity, your build, you know, the building of your foundation, knowledge, all that, wisdom. It does feel like there's a block, And it feels like, it has to do with really, I feel like other people's beliefs that may have become your own, like things that were said to you. I can only imagine being, because I remember things that my mother said that now I know, I understand was just her humanness, right? But now I think, oh man, what did I say to, like, what do my kids think about, right? What does Jen think about? Anyway, so this is cutting those ties to what can be other people's beliefs, right? So it feels like it's connected. I wish I could think of, like, I feel like I just simply need to say every day, like, I expect good things to happen, and therefore they do. But I feel like this is also in, like, what do I do? Again, I know my daughter receives all these epiphanies. Okay, so I do feel like there's a block there. We have the star, can be Aquarius. That's your hopes, your dreams, your wishes. We have the Five of Wands. I'm taking these right down the middle. The Princess of Swords, the Two of Wands, and then the King of Cups. What if I was to say, I can't really tell you who, the next, or who will be the love of your life, but what I can tell you, it will be something very, very fulfilling. Whether it be this Emperor to the Empress, right? King of Cups tells me this is someone who wants to be in a relationship. And again, it could be the Emperor, and listen, I needed to go through, like, this, my own spiritual journey. I feel like just be careful that you don't get caught in drama, because drama is not going to serve you. Other people's drama will then become your drama. So try to, like, no. Even though the Princess of Swords, I do feel like, is the energy of really learning one's voice. You know what I mean? Like really learning one's truth. And then the Two of Wands is movement, is the path now opens. I love the Wands path. You think I'd love the Cups path, but I love the Wands path because it's full of adventure and passion. But that doesn't mean everything goes great. It just means that you are capable of, the lows and the highs, right? And sometimes those lows are just realizations. You know what I mean? So I think I'm gonna leave it there because I think I'm over talking. I have no clue which card to read. Quiet, gratitude, open your heart, and faith. I think I should read faith. Faith, interesting. Faith is my granddaughter's, my daughter Jennifer's youngest daughter, Faith. So it's interesting I chose that. The question you're asking involves a situation that is testing your faith. Nonetheless, this card indicates that more faith is needed. Everything will resolve itself in a divinely ordered way over time, even if presently no solutions are in sight. Prayers are often answered in unexpected ways, as will be the case for this situation. Leave it in the hands of God, who in his infinite wisdom already knows how to resolve everything. God, Mother Mary, and the angels can see your future, and it is bright. Have faith, dear one, so that you can enjoy each precious moment on your pathway to your beautiful tomorrow. Amen. 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 Beautiful. I love you guys. I thank you for every way that you support my channel. Just love you. I feel like you needed this reading. You can let me know through your comments. And I have to feel like when my daughter's going through something, so are you. Like, I feel that connection. I feel we're all drawn together for a reason, and that's to help each other. It's to help each other. And sometimes our difficult experiences become the light to someone else. So, how beautiful and what a blessing. I love you guys. I will see you next time at our table. Bye-bye.